Welcome everyone to the Inside Java Newscast, where we cover recent developments in the OpenJDK community. I'm Nikolai Parlock, Java developer advocate at Oracle, and today we're going to talk about how we can get a function like 4x times y minus sine xy to be executed on the GPU, your graphics card's processing unit, or in a distributed cluster, or as part of a link-like mechanism in Java, or how Java code can differentiate it. But mostly the graphics card aspect, because executing Java code on the GPU unlocks the whole world of machine learning. Ready? Then let's dive right in. So what are we really talking about here? Big picture, I want to express some query or computational logic, like the function I mentioned, in my Java code, and then pass it to some library, which needs to analyze the expression and check whether it makes sense in its domain. If so, it translates the expression and processes it in its environment, for example, by sending it to the GPU for execution. So the first step is for me to express the computational logic. The most natural way to do that would be to write a Java method, but what artifacts can a library get out of it? The Java source code itself, its representation as an abstract syntax tree in AST during compilation, the bytecode generated by the compiler, or a method handle or javalang reflect method instance at runtime. The problem is that none of these are good artifacts to analyze or translate the logic. To work with Java source code, you need to build half a compiler. To get to the AST, you, again, need your own compiler or break into Java C internals and deal with the fact that the AST is somewhat idiosyncratic and contains artifacts of the Java language that complicate your work here. Bytecode is a low-level instruction set that almost always requires uplifting into a less detailed level of abstraction. Reflection, on the other hand, is too abstract. It knows modules, packages, classes, and methods, but it stops there. It has no understanding of or access to what's going on inside a method. Wegen dieser Einschränkungen müssen Projekte in diesem Bereich harte Arbeit leisten. Tornado VM zum Beispiel. Um Java-Code zu verstehen und zu GPU-Kernels zu übersetzen, verwendet es einen ganzen Compiler, GraalJIT um genau zu sein, und greift auf dessen Intermediate Representation des Codes zu und verarbeitet ihn weiter. Andere Projekte behelfen sich, indem sie die Logik als Strings ausdrücken oder dadurch Datenstrukturen zu erstellen, welche die Berechnung darstellen.
Ces approches fonctionnent, mais elles sont loin d'être optimales. Imaginez à la place une solution qui vous permette d'écrire du code Java simple et qui l'accepte en tant qu'expression lambda ou référence de méthode. Cette solution pourra alors travailler avec cette lambda directement. Elle pourrait l'interpréter en tant que routine exécutable sur un GPU, ou bien en tant qu'élément d'une commande SQL, ou encore en tant qu'expression à la link, ou encore en tant que fonction mathématique, ou enfin en tant que procédure de traitement qui pourrait être exécutée sur une grille de calcul.
Dar cum ar putea Java să susțină toate aceste concepte și limbaje? Parcurgându-le iterativ și introducându-le direct în specificația limbajului Java, ar fi o muncă de Sisif, datorită numărului mare de limbaje posibile, iar efortul necesar pentru a evolua specificația și implementarea Java ar duce de asemenea la o confuzie cu adevărat babiloniană, cu diverse potențial conflictuale modele de cod în același limbaj.
Що якби у Java з'явився би механізм, який би дозволив бібліотекам реалізовувати підтримку самостійно? Це не лише позбавило б від багатьох складнощів, як у специфікації, так і у середовищі виконання. Це б ще розблокувало потужність екосистеми Java для забезпечення інновацій за допомогою конкуруючих рішень для загальних проблем, а також нішевих рішень для нішевих проблем, які в будь-якому випадку ніколи б не потрапили до специфікації.
And this is exactly what the brand new Project Babylon sets out to accomplish. Its main thrust is code reflection. Another important exploration is the so-called Heterogeneous Accelerator Toolkit HAT for GPU computation. Let's have a look at both. In early August, Paul Sandoz, library architect at Oracle, presented on this topic at the JVM Language Summit. In fact, most of what I've said so far is just a summary of that talk that I highly recommend you check out if you have deeper interest in this topic. In that talk, he presented the concept of code reflection, which is an enhancement of Java reflection as we know it today. Programmers would identify an area of source code, maybe by annotating a method or by passing it as a lambda or method reference, for which Java would then build a so-called code model that can be accessed at compile time and at runtime. The cold model describes the Java program in a symbolic form, down to individual variable declarations, method calls, arithmetic operations, etc. It's a detailed description of that program, much like bytecode, but instead of being designed and optimized for execution by the JVM, it targets libraries that need to access, analyze, and transform a Java program, and it has APIs that allow just that. An interesting aspect that Paul pointed out is that there is no one level of abstraction that suits all use cases. Instead, he envisages an interval of abstraction within which the code model can be lowered and lifted. That would allow libraries to implement a wide variety of language interpretations based on Java, from math to machine learning to Link.
I think we can do better than Link.
Okay, maybe even better than Link, but importantly, also GPGPU. General purpose computing on a GPU. Let's have a look. The term GPGPU describes computation on a graphical processing unit that is not intended to produce an image, but to perform general computation that would classically be assigned to the CPU. Why would you do that? Well, the GPU in the PC recording this, for example, has over 4,000 cores. If done right, GPGPU can lead to ridiculous speedups. And there are a number of projects enabling Java code to offload computation that way, for example, Aparapi and the aforementioned Tornado VM. One of the Aparapi veterans is Oracle's Gary Frost, who started putting code reflection into practice to build HAT, the Heterogeneous Accelerator Toolkit, and he presented his results at that same JVMLS. HAT requires all data that goes to or comes from the GPU to be stored off heap because that makes things easier and faster. For example, by allowing the GPU to allocate data directly. It uses Project Panama's foreign function and memory API to handle off-heap data without a headache. And thanks to FFM's support for mapping complex objects, there is no need to slice them into primitive arrays. HAT can use FFM to map complex objects to, for example, C99 data layouts that the GPU can use directly. As for the code that needs to be executed, HAT relies on code reflection to interpret it. So developers can write somewhat normal Java code, somewhat normal because there are still stark differences between the JVM and GPUs. For example, only one of them knows what an exception is, while the other has a multi-tier memory hierarchy. So somewhat normal Java code on one side, and after translation through code reflection and the new class file API, GPU architecture specific code on the other side. There's already a prototype that does this, and its performance looks pretty good. I'm not in this space, so I can't really judge the details, but for facial recognition on Gary's laptop, no less, the OpenCL code HAT produced performed 10 times faster than the parallel code written in Java, which was already about 7 times faster than the sequential implementation. That's pretty impressive to me, but I'm sure there's much, much more to gain once vendors get their hands on this and start creating optimized translations. So where are we on this project? Since JVMLS in early August, Project Babylon was founded with Paul Sandals as its lead, so it's still early days. But he's already planning to release the code reflection prototype in the coming weeks, and HAT might be bundled with it. While the plan for code reflection is to evolve, stabilize, and eventually release as part of OpenJDK, HAT has a different trajectory. Instead of baking one GPGPU API into the JDK, HAT is planned to stand as one of many outside libraries that allow Java on the GPU. As part of that, its next steps are to work with GPU vendors to agree on common sets of data types for the API to define. As for the backend specific implementations, for example for CUDA or OpenCL, the goal is to have the respective vendors implement theirs. If you want to learn more about all of this, watch the JVMLS presentations by Paul Sandals about code reflection, Gary Frost about HAT, and while you're there, Juan Fomeros about Tornado VM. All three are super interesting. They're linked in the description, or you can check out all JVMLS videos in this playlist. Don't forget to like and share the video so more Java developers get to see it, and subscribe so I'll see you again in 2 weeks. So long!